Namaste all and welcome back to Solstices. So in this video you will know what is the June solstice and why it is the longest day of the year than the rest of the days. So June solstice is the longest day of the year for the northern hemispherians than the rest of the days of the year, and they also face the shortest night time on the same day. Let's understand the whole concept with this earth that I have made from the ball. I know it's a red or more look like a Mars, but for the sake of understanding, just consider this as an earth. And actually, in fact, if you would have seen the earth around 4.5 billion years ago, you have seen the earth like you would have seen the earth like this one. Okay, but let's come to the point. I have marked the latitude lines on this ball. It's actually not the oblate spheroid same as our earth, but just sake of understanding, just consider this is an Arctic circle on the north. This is the north pole, and at the down this is the south pole. And you will see the Arctic circle at 66.5 degrees north, and at the center there is the equator plane cutting the earth at the center at 0 north, and above that just there is the Tropic of Cancer. You can see that 23.5 degree north, and similarly on the other side 23.5 degree south there is the Tropic of Capricorn, and at the bottom there is the Antarctic circle at 66.5 degrees south. I know the video is flipped because I'm shooting this with the selfie camera, but let's get started to see the concept. And as you know, Earth not only rotates around the Sun but also rotates around itself. So before the collision of Moon, Earth, according to one theory, before the collision with the Moon, Earth was rotating around like itself like this one. But when after the collision with the Moon, it has get tilted like this one to the vertical around 23.45 degrees. From that collision, Earth started its rotation like this one. Okay, around the Sun. So this is the axis of Earth passing through its center, and at this point the polaris starts over there. Here is the demonstration. Consider for a while this is our Sun and this is our Earth. So it's on the 21st June or the summer solstice. The Earth is tilted now towards the Sun, okay, with the vertical around 23.45 degrees, as you can see. So this above the equator towards the north pole, this is the northern hemisphere, and down the equator towards the south pole, this is the southern hemisphere. So northern hemisphere is more tilted towards this Sun on the solstice. So this area, as you can see, is the much larger area is tilted towards the Sun, okay. So as the speed is constant, the circumferential speed is constant, that means if you are living here, you would have to travel the whole distance, okay. And at the similar time, you can see here the really smaller area, and this area is in the dark, and so this area is in the daylight, okay. So here you can see the length is more. So simply to measure the length, just take a string and start your length here, and from this one, suppose you are living in another hemisphere, and you travel to this point till the night, okay. So you covered that much distance. So actually eventually you covered this much of distance, and just mark here, I'm gonna cut the string. So this distance is your day distance of the solstice, and let's consider our night distance on this day. As you can see, your night starts from here, and you travel to this point exactly. Okay, so just like make it parallel to there, and your night ends on here, okay. So your night distance is something about here. So this is your night. So if you compare, this is our day distance and this is our night distance, so you can say the comparable difference between the same. So this is your shorter night and this is your longest day of the solstice. So on this day the night will be shorter, because simply consider this, Earth is rotating like this wind, so you will face the really shortest distance for the night.
and thereby early shortest time of the night. And for the day, you would have to travel. Suppose consider, here is your morning and you are traveling towards the west like this. So you would have to cover the really largest distance of the year on this day. Okay. So, but the circumferential speed is constant and distance is increasing. So at the cost of the time, you would have to travel this whole distance. So that's why the day is longer on the 21st June than the rest of the days of the years. Okay. So, and talking about this, the Arctic Circle, here is something fascinating happens. As it tilts your 23.45 degrees towards the moon, towards the sun, this area you can see is totally in the daylight. So 6 months here is the day. So 24 hours day here for this next 6 months till the equinox. Okay. So and here on the downside you can see, on the downside this is in the night. So 24 hours of night in the Antarctic Circle in the Antarctic Circle for the next 6 months. Okay. Till the equinox reaches. So talking of the facts of the solstice, this area, northern hemisphere, the sun radiation will hit the more area, or the more of the sun radiation will hit the northern hemisphere. So on this you can see the Tropic of the Cancer, which is 23.5 degrees north, the sun declination is right over here. That means the sun will hit the sun rays, as you know, right, light travels in the straight line. So sun rays will make exactly 90 degrees over the Tropic of the Cancer here. And for the other areas, it will also hit the more radiation than the southern hemisphere. So except the equinoxes days, for other days of the year, the day length is not the same always for the other positions of the Earth.